Hello, I'm Duke of the Bump. Welcome to Let's Play Popful Male Redux, episode number 10. Aww, look at the sleepy gaw. I have to say, this is the best idle animation in the game so far. It looks kind of like a Snorlax from this angle. Anyway, I'm delighted that you've watched from episode 1 to episode 10. Oh.
That's the volcano you're getting a whiff of. Sulfur. Some parts of the mine cut through vents in the volcano, and the smell fills the mine. After a while, you don't even notice it.
I'm looking for an old dwarf guy. Have you seen one here lately?
Couldn't say. See, I've only been here a few days myself. Ask some of the other miners. Maybe they know.
Thanks for nothing. You deserve to stink. Bad.
Wow. What is up with that accent? That was the worst accent I've ever heard in a video game. And even the accent aside, that was some pretty poor voice acting. What was that even supposed to be? It sounded like vaguely Scandinavian, but not really a good Scandinavian accent. Ugh, it was awful.
Hey, have you seen an old dwarf in this stinkhole?
Mumbles hasn't been down here in a long time. Try the sanctuary at the top of the mine.
And that guy looks exactly the same, but he just has kind of a generic, gruff American accent. Wow, I don't know. Whoa, it's Guile's cool cousin, Lyle. What are you doing, operating a shop in Popful Mail? At least he's friendly enough. We are going to buy some equipment for Gaul and Tat, since they are my preferred characters. For Gaul, I will get his Iron Claw, and he doesn't have any armor, so he is much better defended than he was. Let's go ahead and sell that fireball, since we're not going to be using that much. Do I have any bullion? Yeah, I have one. Let's go ahead and sell that. And let's switch over to Tat. Get you some healing as well. And let's see, I can buy... We already have the Electro Cane. Can't afford the robe yet. Let's go ahead and buy the charm. And sell our old crappy Earth charm. The Gale charm is obviously superior. How much more do we need? About 1,000 to get the robe. And what does my Earth robe sell for? 600? Nah. Let's hang on to that. So we'll stick with the Earth Robe for now. And go ahead and switch back over to Gaul. Equip his claw, his plate mail, and his steel band. Alright, excellent. And the reason I bought the claw is because it is a melee attack. And like I was talking about in a previous video, neither... Oh, you have more to say.
I can't figure out that new watchman. It's hotter than hell in here and he's drinking coffee. What a goof!
Yeah, what a goof indeed. But now we have Gaul for the melee, and we have Tat for the ranged, and we have Mail to fall back on just in case Tat and Gaul get dangerously injured. So yes, we are after Mumbles, the dwarf.
It's here. I can smell it. Come on, Gold. Show your stuff.
Hey, have you seen an old dwarf in this stinkhole?
Jumping catfish. It's a cursed turn gollywog. Ah! Get away from me, you beast. Wait a minute. I never saw a talking gollywog. So what in tarnation are you? Well, anyway... Yeah, I seen the dwarf in here sometimes. He sells gadgets to us miners.
Good. Where does he live? Blah.
Don't know, don't care. I'm a-digging for gold, Junior, and I ain't going home to my woman until I find some gold, gold, gold. Talk to Papa. Tell him how to find you.
Oh, great. Now he chooses to lose his mind. Just wonderful.
Wow, these guys are kind of assholes. A gollywog. Indeed. Of course, Gaul's kind of an asshole too, so I guess it's what he has coming to him.
Hey, have you seen an old dwarf in this stink hole?
Yikes! It's the biggest freaking bat I've ever seen! Scram! Beat it! Get out of here! Ouch! Hey, you bit me, you fat no-good friggin' parasite!
Ha! You deserved it, you mountain hick! Ugh.
Jesus. So hostile. We have a ladder leading up and a door leading out. Let's head up the ladder first, see what's up there. We got some information indicating that our goal is at the top of this mountain. Shoring up the tunnels. What does that mean? Sounds kind of like bullshit to me. It sounds like the video game does not want us to go in that direction, so it came up with some BS to make us go the other direction. These cloud things, actually, let's switch to, well, I can probably take him out with Gaul. You can only hit him when the eyeball is visible. These things really remind me of an enemy from the Kirby games. I forget which one it appeared in first. I think it was in Kirby's Adventure for the NES. Or maybe it was Kirby Enthusiasm. I don't know. It's a boss, which is a similar looking cloud with an eyeball, but much bigger. And I could have brought Tad out to take care of those, but with Gaul's extremely high jump, he was the man for the job, I believe. So yes, thank you for watching. Double digit episode, pretty big deal. If this is your first episode, I don't know how you found it, but if it is the first episode you've seen, I recommend going back and starting with episode number one. You probably won't have much of an idea of what's going on. And then again, the story in this game isn't really that deep. You might be able to just jump in and enjoy it. Wow, 2 gold bullions. I have a feeling they put those there for a reason. I wonder what that reason could be. Also, those were really tough enemies. They took like 10 hits apiece. Possibly more. Let's see. I don't think I can jump across there. It looks like that wall up above me would block me from jumping. Let's just head in here and see what we can find. Not really sure why we're looking for a dwarf named Mumbles. I kind of forget that part. Something about following a lead from Muttonhead, trying to find the guy who was giving Muttonhead his orders. I think his name is Kaiser. Hi, mummy. Yeah, these mummies go down a lot more easily than those other ones. Whoa. That's kind of a weird enemy. A tombstone that lunges at you. I have to say, that's a pretty good tombstone, though. When I die, that's what I want my marker to be. Just a stab of stone with a skull on it. No kind of identifying markers or anything. Just a skull. It's like, yeah, you know what's up. I'm totally dead. I think that's where we have to go, but let's check over here just in case. Another mummy. No real reason to kill him, but why not? We do need to start collecting money if we want to buy... if we want to buy Tat's armor, and also Mail's new equipment. We'll need a few thousand for that. So yeah, looking for Mumbles for some reason. We have reason to believe that this is the next clue in discovering where we need to go next. Whoa, this place looks pretty special. Wow, more bullion. I'm gonna be rich after this. Rich, I tells ya. Oh, hi.
Oh, monsters have stormed the sanctuary. Oh, I'm trapped. Get away.
Relax. I'm not going to eat you. I am not a monster.
I'm Glug, a dwarf master artisan. Are you sure you don't eat people? You know, I'm mostly fat and wouldn't be very tasty.
God doesn't eat people. God eats fish. Say, if you're a dwarf, why don't you have a beard?
That's the old look. Nowadays, pretty much anything goes. Some of the dwarves don't like it, but I suppose their ways of thinking will eventually die out.
Well, these days, God runs into many strange elves and dwarves. They even make French people seem normal.
Whoa. Elves.
You know, I have a good friend who's an elf. Maybe you know him. His name's Slick.
Slick? Slick? This guy's friends with Slick?
Oh, so you do know him. That guy's the greatest.
He's one of the nuttiest fruitcakes I've ever met. How do you stand him?
Well, maybe you caught him on an off day. He's really very nice. Anyway, enough chit-chat. What can I do for you?
Well, can you tell me about the Black Seal?
Sure, I know about the legend of the Black Seal. I've read about it on the Great Stone Wall. I once asked Mumbles to explain it to me, but he's not too keen on talk, so all I know is what I've seen on the wall. And I'm afraid that's not much.
Thanks for nothing, Chub-Chub-Chubbo. Gah.
Man, huge slam on French people out of nowhere. Not cool, Victor Ireland. Not cool. I didn't know the Irish hated the French so much. That's why they call him Victor Ireland, right? Because he's from Ireland? That's how names work. Alright, the trip down, much easier than the trip up. Whee! Oh, hi.
Do you sometimes feel less than fresh? I know I do.
Okay. So yes, we spoke with Mumbles, which hopefully is an arbitrary point that will allow us to go in the direction we were previously blocked from going. That sounds like something a video game would do. Hi.
I wish the gold would speak up. I can't find it if it won't talk to me.
Interesting. How long have you felt this way? How long has the gold talked to you? What a chump. Yeah, what a chump down here with a pickaxe looking for gold. Kind of like someone else I know. I mean, I'm not going to name any names, but No, I mean, keep doing what you're doing. Looks pretty fruitful. Venuncio. Okay. Sounds like a pleasant fellow. Hi, are you Venuncio?
Hold it, frog face. Where do you think you're going?
Far from your ugly mug, lizard lips.
Ha, ha. Everyone's a comedian these days.
Look, am I getting through to you? This area is closed, off limits, and out of bounds. So scram!
Really? Are you sure about that? fine. Now to figure out how to get through this arbitrary barrier. Let's go back and talk to people and see if we can find some clues. What about you? I don't think that was Venuncio I was talking to. His guards seem pretty touchy, though. Pretty touchy as well. No, that leads back out to Cloudland. What about you, Crazy Pants?
Those creepy guards won't let me pass. Can you help God find a way to get through? Yes, yes, yes.
Well, there might be one way. No, I don't really remember too good. I've got to keep digging for gold so I can go home. Now, if and I had some gold bars, my life would be so much easier. I might just remember something.
Gold bars? Well, I have some gold bars. You want these?
Well, I'll tell you, that plan to get past the guards is starting to come back to me. But you know, 4 gold bars just might speed my memory up.
4 gold bars? Jesus, do I look like I'm made of money? How many do I have? Okay, I have 3. That means I just need one more, and I think I know where to find it. Tune in next time for Let's Play Popful Mail Redux, a new episode on Wednesday. I will locate the last gold bar I need, and I will hopefully get past those guards up there and speak with this Venuncio fellow, who sounds delightful. Good night, everybody.